Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Very well.
Good.
It's 10 to 5.
What's the time?
10 to 5.
10 to 5.
10 to 5. That's 4:50 in radio disc jockey terms.
Yes.
Hello, my name's Rossie from the Radio City Breakfast Show. Entrez, s'il vous plaît.
What's on the big show today? We're talking about the Brits. We've got a forfeit for our producer, Jay, who we all had a little bet yesterday as to who would win the best British band. And he who lost has to walk down one of the main streets in Liverpool, dressed up as a giant whoopee cushion.
Nice.
I'll produce the whoopee cushion fancy dress outfit a little bit later on.
Switching on the lights at the top of the Radio City Tower. There you go. We're now officially lit up.
My alarm clock, everyone asks me what time do you get up, it's off at 4. I snooze till about 10 past, and then I get up and a shower. And you know what? I don't feel any worse at 4 o'clock than I used to feel, I'd say 20 past 6, we used to get up to do the mid-morning show. Preparation, I think, is key. And anybody who goes, I can ad-lib, I don't need to prepare, really, I think they need to take a look at themselves. I prepare in a way that it all sounds quite ad-libbed, in the same way. You know, Ant and Dec, they don't turn up 2 minutes before their Saturday Night Takeaway TV show and ad-lib that. It doesn't happen, but they make it look ad-libbed and they make it look brilliant.
Do you like my filing system for my various hours of the show? This, you see, is for the 6 o'clock hour. This one, you'll find, is for the 7 o'clock hour. And you'll never guess which one this is for.
8 o'clock
hour, yes. 8 o'clock hour. So, we'll touch on that a little bit later on.
So I enjoy actually putting bits and bobs together. So I do an hour and a half in the evening, and then I get into work about 10 to 5, and then whatever's happened overnight, I can go through it and talk about it, because if I've prepared it, then I don't have to go chasing it while I'm on air, therefore give it more concentration. But I don't do it in a script way. I do everything in my own handwritten notes. I don't type anything. I don't put stuff through the computer. It's in rough handwritten notes. So it does always come across as ad-libbed, and most of it is, to be perfectly honest.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you, son?
Good, are you?
Not too bad. Sleep well.
Malcolm, having nightmares about this
Wookie
cushion costume.
How would I sum up my job? Basically, it's just making sure, making sure everything is running plan, running smoothly. Making sure Rossi's happy, making sure Claire's happy. And it's kind of a bit of everything, you know, you're looking at the timings and working out your timings, you're prepping the show, you're giving them as much info as you need on, say for instance, we book a guest. That's all done through me, and then I'll prep the interview with the guest, or give them all his facts and figures about a certain celebrity. I'm making the brews is a big part of the job. And just overseeing the whole output of the show.
Oh, in anticipation. Oh my
god. Exciting. To be honest, it actually doesn't bother me getting up really early in the morning, because I'm very much a morning person. Once I'm awake, and that's it. I'm just very much kind of, I'm not so wide awake at 9:30 at night, but in the morning I just literally bounce out of bed, like the bird starts singing and little wibbly wobbly world of Claire Simo.
Oh my god, you see me
as that
100 times.
Yeah, I know, but look, you know, your brassiere's stinking.
No, it's not. I'm
actually
deliberately
putting
something
on
where it's like
tasteful.
You're not really tasteful
about that. Can we get a close-up? Can we get a close-up of her tasteful cleavage?
That's not cleavage.
Oh my giddy.
That's not cleavage.
Oh, you're like someone that stands in the corner of a shopping mall swinging a bottle of old English cider.
We are back on the radio again. It's good to be back in the COA here. Good morning, Jay Hine.
Good morning. How are we?
Very good. Executive producer of the show. Looking cool this morning. You do look like you could be a member of Take That.
Really?
Yeah, you got
Take
that look.
Take That's a little bit old for me.
How could you possibly turn that round to an insult?
Yeah, this
You're
is
about
it.
45.
Get lost. You're not.
Firstly,
fit to kiss
none of them are in the 40s. So, factually, you're very, very incorrect. Again,
are they not 40?
No, they're not 40 yet. Maybe Gary Barlow might be about 40. Stone.
He was
late
40.
30s.
Oh,
though.
Don't you be cruel about my Gary.
How did I get into radio?
He was.
I made this bizarre transition from being a chef. I trained to be a chef. and eventually worked my way into radio. And people say, how did you get from one to the other? While I was training to be a chef back in Armagh and Belfast in Northern Ireland, I was doing what they called back in the day discos, mobile discos and things.
I got into radio because I was covering for somebody. Just literally, I was working in Jag House. They were asking people off the street, because that's good, me coming in off the street, isn't it, to come in and read the travel. And I literally just came in, read it for one day, and then ended up covering for somebody else when she went off on leave. And then they offered me the job full time. And that was like 10 years ago, the last time I was at City. And when I left to have my two children, Claire Morrow took over from me. And then she went off on maternity leave and I came back. So it went out very nicely.
And I didn't get the real radio bug, despite loving radio, until I moved to London. And I got into, there was more varieties, more choices in London to listen to. And I thought, I love this. And I actually contacted a guy who worked on the then old Radio 1. Who advised me to do hospital radio. So while I was cooking and being a chef, and I was quite successful in that field, I took up a job at a hospital radio station, which is a brilliant training ground.
Well, I started 10 years ago now, to be honest. I'd done voluntary work. I worked on our evening show, and I'd done 3 years without getting paid a single penny. And then I started with Pete Price, who does the Late Show on City, which was obviously a little bit crazy at times.
Went to Australia, I worked around as a chef, I did a little bit of radio out there, came back, started to get rejection after rejection, I made demo after demo, and really perseverance was the thing that paid off, because I'd cut this demo and I'd sent it out, and someone said, this is the best demo you've ever made, and sure enough, from that demo, I got 3 job offers from 5 applications, which wasn't bad.
I'm Richard Maddock, I'm the station director of Radio City 96.7. We meet with Rossie twice a week after the show, and it's really, really important. As a radio presenter, when you're in that studio 5 days a week, 4 hours a day, it's often very difficult when you get out of the studio to realise what's worked and what hasn't, because you're kind of caught up in the moment of it all. And it's really, really important that we do that. It gives us a chance to talk about things that have worked, to talk about things that haven't, come up with ideas for what we want to do in the future. And for an hour or so, it's a chance just to take stock of what we're doing as a show.
What's going on? Brits.
We had a good old chat about the Brits last night. We picked out our best and the very highlights and best bits, of which there were many.
Rossi's great. Rossie is an absolute perfectionist. Beats himself up over the smallest thing. His determination to do the very, very best he can is phenomenal.
I always think I can do better. I always strive to do better, and I do that in most things in life. Work, be a better dad, you know, go to the gym, work harder. I just spur myself on. I do beat myself up, and I'm always constantly being told, give yourself a break, but I think if I sit back and kick back and think I've arrived, that's the day I think I need to quit radio. Oh,
yes, Jay Hine, by the way, he will be walking down Church Street around midday today, 12:30. You can't miss him because he'll be dressed in a giant whoopee cushion. You've not seen the whoopee cushion yet.
No.
I will bring it in after the 8:30 news.
I really don't want to do this, you know.
Hey?
I really don't want to do it.
Sonny Jim.
You know what? I feel a bit funny all of a sudden.
You do feel a bit funny. You look a bit funny. Standby traffic and travel is on the way next.
Dress last year because he didn't get the Brit nomination right. So we picked a category, which was Best Group. And of course, me being a huge Take That fan, I opted for Take That. Jade shouted me down, said, oh, you don't know anything about music. It's going to be Mumford & Sons.
And Mumford & Sons lost. So I was gutted because I had to walk up Church Street dressed in a giant whoopee cushion outfit.
So we did. We marched him around Liverpool dressed as a whoopee cushion, which was very, very, very funny and very much deserved.
And just to see Jay's head coming out of that was very, very funny indeed. It looked like a big split condom with Jay's head at the top of it. And he did agree to walk down Church Street, which he did do, but he didn't do it with much smile on his face. He was very grumpy about having to do it, but he did do it. So thumbs up to Jay Hine for fulfilling the forfeit.
So give Jay a little round of applause, everybody. Give him a round of applause. Whoopee!
So stand up and be counted from Litherland to Lydiot and show the world you're not a wimp and play the Village Idiot.
Officially anywhere on the planet, this is the only quiz where the loser stays on. And we welcome back for day number 3 today from the beautiful village of Aintree. It is Sarah Nichols. Good morning, Sarah.
Good morning, everyone.
Morning. Hello.
Morning. How are you today, Sarah?
I'm fine. Have I hope you... you're all good.
Yeah, we're all great, actually. One sleep till the weekend, Sarah.
Whoopee!
Playing in your opposite corner this morning, Whoopee, yes, Jay, Whoopee!
One of my favourite features on the show is, it's got to be the Village Idiot. We do it every morning, 8:30, and we have a different person on every day to take on our idiot. And the idiot is the person that lost the day before, and sometimes it can go boobs up, because we had one idiot that was on, I think he was on for 12 days a couple of weeks ago, didn't get any questions right at all. But it's one of them, you know, a live caller on the show, anything can happen, and it normally does.
Andy, you are from the beautiful village of Fazakli, so as soon as you think you know an answer to a question, first of all, shout out Fazakli, and we'll come to you. Sarah Nichols, what do you shout out?
Idiot!
Village idiot! You do indeed. Right, question number one, here we go. Which band featured members Faye Towser, Lee Latchford and H...
Exactly.
Yes, exactly. Is correct. I'm afraid, Sarah, you're back tomorrow morning. You do understand that?
I do. Will you stop asking Brit Award questions? You didn't watch it.
You didn't watch the Brit Awards. Were you watching? Were you watching My Big Fat Gypsy Wedding?
Yeah.
Everybody else seemed to be as well. It actually won the TV ratings that night. So I'm sorry about that. I'll try to avoid any Brit Award questions tomorrow morning. Okay.
Thank you.
Because tomorrow you return to the Radio City Breakfast Show, Rossie and Co, as...
The Village Idiot.
Ciao, baby.
Bye.
The
Village
Idiot. Back tomorrow after 8:30 with Rossie and Co on Radio City 96.7.
Here's Mike Fly, Shine a Light, Radio City Breakfast. It is Rossie and Co.
Never resting on my laurels.
Right.
So,
Rossie?
Yes, sir.
The tax man's in reception for you.
The tax man? Yeah, he owes me a rebate, the cheeky bugger.
For sure.
Yeah.
He's funny, there's a couple of coppers with him as well.
Coppers?
Yeah.
No, I want notes, lads. I don't want
them.
Coppers, I want
I'll
notes.
I'll go stall them, you get out of the room.
Yeah. Well, it doesn't take that long, but to do a great variety of great questions on a daily basis,
day in, it takes a lot of talent.
Quiz.com. I don't use anything straight out of my noggin, dear boy.
So you never use any.
No, I don't. I don't use anything, as you well know. But all your questions are all the same. Who makes the hot pot and color? that you've actually written that 6 different occasions, and I've only asked you to write the questions once, brother.
Having a breather from Rossie, maybe just give us a second.